It's Sunday, September the 28th, 2014, and we're just about to start the Frank Jordan Show with the Earth Mind Healers. Tonight, our show is Healings and Meditations, where we'll be talking, starting off with the photon belt information, and we'll just take it from there. So here we go, introducing Frank Jordan.
Our energetic lives through the subtle energy fields. And this has been predicted for some time, and I hadn't paid too much attention to it because I thought it was probably just another metaphysical mind trip, you know. But it is real. These energies are real, and they are having a direct effect on how we think and act, and opening up to these and understanding how to utilize these energies and how to allow them to affect your life, how to shift your consciousness, how to raise your consciousness, how to adjust your system so that you can take advantage of this. Your mic's opened in. So that's what we'll do. And I know...
That was me, sorry.
Kimberly is with us tonight. And we really appreciate her presence because she's been working primarily toward this for a long period of time with extended groups and the Crystal Skulls and all of that. So welcome, Kimberly.
Hi, everyone. It's so great to be here. And when I say here, I'm not quite sure what dimension we're working on these days because they're all sort of fanning in and fanning out. But it's really good to be here with everybody grounded.
Well, let's talk about the physics. I always begin with the physics of metaphysics every time I try to explain something to someone so that they understand and realize it's just not woo-woo land we're talking about here. This is very real physical God-force stuff we're working with, and understanding gives us a better control over our response to it. So can you give us a little background on the physics of the photon belt and what's happening?
Well, here's what I'll do. I'll let the information come in the way that I normally do so that spirit sort of speaks through me. And I certainly don't profess to be an expert in any way, shape, or form, but as someone who is, living in an expanded field of consciousness with this Lumerian crystal skull, thanks to Glenn and Susan, it has been activated and been activating the grids since 2011. Essentially, what the firing the grids has turned out to mean is the keys, these crystals, these liquid crystals are acting as keys to open up portals in this particular third dimension. What does that mean to someone who's carrying it around? Well, what we're finding is that the direct responses to the crystalline grid and the water that's within all of us, it allows us to interact and interface with energetic bodies that we're finding out now. As the information's coming in, we're finding out that there are certain people on this planet that are affected by the portals that are opening. They're being assisted by this purification process. We're finding out that some of the people on this planet have been actually used by some of these races, different races. Some know them as Anunnaki and different races that had come in and done a little interference here. This purification process is assisting in a clemency process, which is a word that I've just come to really understand recently. There is an interface that's happening with some of these hybrid souls on the planet. For so long, they've been operating in the unseen realms, in the fifth and sixth and, pardon me, not the fifth and sixth, sorry, lower than the fourth, but they've been operating in the and this is what I wanted you to go into some explanation about for me so I can understand this better, but the subtle bodies that you talked about, Frank, there's three different layers, I believe, and that's what's actually being affected now by this photonic amplification process. So if you could just sort of weave that in for us, what I'll explain is the effects that these crystal skulls and the hypervigilant awareness that the individuals like heart mind, earth mind, universal mind group gatherings such as this, what's happening is we are amplifying these doors to clemency. Rich talks about this a lot. He's been helping spirits pass over to the other side. Well, now that the photon belt is actually closer to us, it started off with just our galaxy hitting the photon belt back in 2009, I believe, Cryon talks about, and then started to go into the quickening in 2012. Well, now we're heading in. The Earth is starting to be affected by that purple, magenta, photonic stardust belt, if you will. With that happening, there is a more immediacy showing up in different humanoid hybrid kind of effects. And they're looking for the angelic bodies, for the light hearts, for the Christed hearts to show them compassion and mercy in order for them to go through a doorway and leave this particular dimension that's about to get very bright, light, and full of joy, and we're about to move into a fifth dimensional vibrational frequency. For us, it's going to be exciting. For those, it's going to be very, very, very discomforting and discomforting is a really nice word for it. There's going to be quite a bit of suffering. They're going to be looking for assistance here very soon because of us going into this photonic belt. So that's sort of what's happening in the day-to-day relationships. And so you can imagine this now on a little bit of a macro with the governments, the people who've been put in places and hoping they weren't going to get found out. And all of a sudden now they're starting to get found out. So this process of reconciliation is upon us. And I know that's a really long answer to a question about photons, but it helps if you ask me questions and then, you know, the information comes out.
Yeah, well, I can relate directly to that because I've been working to this point for like 30 years and didn't understand why I was being directed here and there and not really studying other people's work or other than for confirmation after I could pretty well do something. I wanted to understand more about it. But you've mentioned people who have been selected on Earth to be portals of these energies that are coming in. And I'm pretty sure that I know this group is of that ascension process, primarily because of the level of people that are being drawn together here and the skills that we're developing so rapidly. We have a wonderful group that no matter what question we ask, somebody has an answer, you know. And if the answer isn't forthcoming, then we have channels that open up and the information comes through. But it's been a very progressive thing that we've been working with here. One thing, one learning leads to another, opening up. And basic to it, as I indicated prior, everything is based in physics. It's actually the laws of the universe that we're working with and in here. And when the proper time comes, the next step is opened up. Just like I'm not paying any attention to the photon belt or any other ones else, anybody else that's working the ascension progress. I've just been plugging away here, learning how things work. And passing that information on to the group and anyone else out there that's willing to listen, because that's the foundation, Timmy, of what you're talking about. If you understand how things work, you can do things. If you're just out in airy fairyland, bouncing around from one highfalutin idea to another, and nothing physical being accomplished, then it doesn't do much good. But this group, working with the Earth Mind and the Devic Forces of Consciousness, we're working right in the very levels and forces of and structures that hold all form and reality together. And as we work in understanding of the zero point, it gives us control over what happens to us. And by extending that resonance out of what we do in the Earth Mind meditations, working directly with the Devas of Earth, and the consciousness of Earth Mind that all humans carry and are resonating with as their instinctive consciousness, by working in those levels, we're preparing anyone who's willing to listen. And more important than that, we're impairing Earth Mind itself, because the shift of consciousness in Earth Mind is raising. It's rising up to meet our input and our expectation of what this is all about and for. And would you agree with what you have seen us doing, that's true?
100%, absolutely. And many groups tonight, I know there's a one at 8 o'clock that is set up to be global. And a lot of what's happening is a lot of us may already know this, but we've all been contacted by, I think, our higher guides and selves to be the part of the Earth Ally, you know, alliance here. And those of you that are working with your guides, you know that. And some of us just sort of have this essence where we're just sort of in prayer and in meditation and in contemplation, and we're in presence. And it doesn't even seem like a conversation anymore between me and another. It just is now. It just is. I just operate here as a being that is under instruction, because my job is to work for the big office, as we call it. And in doing that, my ego self is sort of reserved just to kind of keep me from walking out in front of a bus, and to keep my body resting, and to keep my body healthy and doing what it needs to do to function. But for the most part, I'm walking in that meditative state with my antenna up, listening fully for my next instruction, right? For the next right thing to do. And this is what I feel is we've been gathered together, and I've been working with some high level government representatives. And what is actually happening at these top levels is a purification process. And the security and the safety is being put in by our knowing conscious selves. So what's happening, someone was mentioning, when do we put peace in? We're actually linking the chains up for this global unified peace consciousness to unroll. There is such a paradigm shift that's about to happen, that the idea and notion of any kind of authority over a free, sovereign being such as ourselves will just no longer be visible to us. There will be a small remnants of containment that will need to happen for those that are about to be what we'll call disabled in their ability to function in their positions, because they will be directly affected by this God particle that's coming in. And it looks a lot like you and me. So with all this talk in the last year and a half to 2 years of these timelines collapsing, what has come of that in the physical realm here is that you and I have the ability to go up and down that ladder of timeline to work with different dimensional beings as needed. So we've essentially moved ourselves into a superhuman capacity where the others who came here to give orders and take orders of the hybrid species, I guess, are finding it now. They're going into that sort of heavy, dense, thick muck that they're not able to operate in. Their movements are starting to become like sludge. They're starting to get sort of ill on the inside. They're searching and searching for everything they can do to keep themselves shielded. And the biggest thing that we're noticing right now is those in those very high up places are trying to keep themselves cloaked, but they can no longer cloak. And what's happening is they are becoming absolutely frightened as in that look in the eyes when someone has lost the control of all levers and can no longer operate their ship. Okay, so the fear that's getting ready to be, let's say, burned up in the Phoenix fire, okay, is not actually our fear anymore. It is a tsunami of fear from these hybrids who are absolutely have forgotten that the grace of the God particle comes in to actually balance everything out, and because they've forgotten who they are, they're scared to death, literally, Frank. That's the fear that's on the planet right now, is they're afraid they won't be able to get off the planet.
That's exactly right. When they came in, the demigods, the children of the gods, and and their dominions on down for the last, 7,000-8,000 years, they actually programmed the amnesia in humans and genetically programmed it so we wouldn't recognize or understand what was happening when we entered this photon belt and came back into our higher consciousness. And so even though it's happening automatically and systematically in people, if they don't have an educated understanding of what's happening, a matrix of understanding, they don't know how to relate to it. They just think they're being weird and ill, and they go see a doctor and get some placebos or something. But the fact, you're exactly right on. As this shift is occurring, those who do not let go of their karmic responsibilities and who are responsible for the worth for domination on the earth, those people are reaping the harvest of their density that they created. They created the density in order to hold down the beings of light from ascending or from even recognizing who they are. And that's what's happening right now, is a tremendous recognition is stirring. And everyone we touch, and we don't have to tell them much, you know, just a basic, some clues, they're waking up, they're reaching, they're looking. And the Internet's just filling up with wonderful things now that people can go and find that will enlighten them, bring them into the light state. And so I see that as our function, reaching out through Wolfpack Radio, is reaching as many people as it possibly can. And each one of those will touch someone else and touch someone else. It's like a wave that goes around the world. And, of course, the only ones that are reaching and asking and gaining understanding are those who have the potential of moving in through the fourth dimension, because we're in the fourth dimension now, into the fifth dimension. And those who, because that's what the fourth dimension is, it's a transition zone between the third and the fifth. And we've discussed the fifth quite a few times and what that can be, in terms of skill and ability and long life and wonderful lives and being able to utilize the laws of attraction, manifestation, all of that at our will. Those who don't get it, those who are so burdened by the domination force and that patterning and programming, are simply the ones that are causing the turmoil out there right now. It's all a created illusion out there that's happening in Syria and Ukraine and in all the financial stress that's going on around the world. It's all created to hold people in confusion and turn their attention away from examining what's happening to them. And our job is to be available so people can contact us and we can tell them what's happening in every way we possibly can. Would you agree?
Yeah, and I'd like to share something that I have been being given information about, and then that information has been confirmed by a few different sources. So I want to share with you all about what's going on right this minute that's completely correlate with what we're talking about. The actual cancer that is this regime that has had this agenda that has, that had literally rooted itself in our administration is actually, finally being rooted out right now as we speak. Everyone is on notice. All the militias are on notice. What's happening is 40 to 60 nations now, I believe it is, and ratcheting up are all, in alignment with this final takedown of what we would call the last of the fighters, the last of the ones who are in complete denial, who are literally so asleep. They are such victims of insane domination of their own egos. That they're actually needing to be forcefully taken out now. So I know that we've all been watching a lot of wars that we know has been propaganda. But I want you to know this last one, what we're watching right now is actually the battle between good and evil. And if you start watching the news and start seeing different people are showing up to bring the message out. We're hearing from the Pentagon now. We're actually hearing Obama go off script in some of his speeches. You guys got to start watching very closely now because the paradigm is actually shifting right before our eyes, and it's doing it in such a subtle way that it's in order to keep it looking similar to business as usual so that we are catching them all in the fly trap, and that's me speaking it in the nicest way I know how, because I'm trying to keep my level of compassion and understanding up for these last holdouts who have made this a very difficult last stretch for all of us. But I just want you to know that the ISIL, the Levant at the end of ISIL, if you look up the meaning of the word, it actually means to run from debt. Okay, so there's a lot of symbols and codes I could go into. You know, we could be on the show all night. But I just want you to know I've gotten that confirmed, that we are actually in the last ditches of the actual battle between good and evil right now, and actually having them be taken out of our Washington, D.C. location, that Capitol building, the White House, and the New York Federal Reserve will be replevined back to the people, and I have confirmation of that. Okay, so that's where we're at right now.
Well, the problem is there's absolutely nothing in the media, because it is controlled by the cabal, that would indicate any of this, and so we have to go to the social network to find it. And that's that's like wading through a swamp full of reeds trying to find one little reed out there that's got the flower on the end of it that you're looking for. But I guess my point here is that we have to look to find. And sometimes it starts with such a very simple thing, just like the suggestion, hey, look up the photon belt, guys, and see what that'll tell you. Because I was surprised when I pulled that up. I quickly picked out three articles that explained it all to me just perfectly in a way that I'd never heard it explained before, because I hadn't looked for it, really. I've just been plowing along day by day by day doing the basics here, and now it's time to start looking forward and reaching for the stars, because we're there.
Well, that's why this time is called the apocalypse, because it's actually the revealing of things that have been hidden before. Right? We're in the great revelation, the great reconciliation time right now, and we are really coming upon peace. And once the peace gets ready to be announced, I mean, we are really close, guys. The work we're doing behind the scenes is unbelievable. Once we're actually ready to announce the announce peace, we'll be taking over the airwaves, and it will really get, it's almost like we're going to start planning a celebration here really soon. But this last epoch of this good versus evil here is happening, and the main stage is here, Washington, D.C., which is where the corruption has been actually, you know, swelling. So I have to say, keep your eyes real open and diligent and keep your prayers really high. This is the time right now for us to keep our lights really, really bright. We're making a big difference, a big difference.
Well, that's good to know. That's on the outer, in the outer world in reality. And yes, we have to be conscious of that too, because that's what affects us so strongly and holds us in form. But our inner reality, I think, is just as vital and important, that we gain an understanding of what the subtle energy fields are, and the fact that they sustain everything that's physical out there, and it's the desire and will and choice of humans is what's created everything out there, including the domination force and everything it expresses. And it's only through desire and will and intent and focused intelligence that we're going to shift this thing, and we can shift it quite rapidly. I know just the people we reach out here on the level we've been working on, I've had a lot of feedback from people saying that they've been stimulated to look and find and do things they've never been able to do before. And that's one of the things that'll happen, as I understand it, and is that as we do our clearing work, we clear the old negative patterns and forms, because we are just literally biocomputers that have been programmed for thousands of years, and actually genetically programmed from our point of creation to be subjective, to be good laborers, good slaves, and not cause too many problems. But they made the mistake of giving us a few too many genes, and intelligence and self-realization came along with that. Well, with intelligence and self-realization, and becoming an observer of what's happening out there, and not participating in the negativity of it, not buying it, not going along with it, we can't become co-creators of the positive reality. And if the negative reality isn't supported and empowered financially or by acting as soldiers or judges or cops or anything else, if we don't empower that, then it there's no need for it. It just dissipates away. And that's ultimately what will happen. But I read one piece that I'd like to quote some things to all of you here, if I can bring it up on my other computer. It's explaining how the photon belts and everything. But there's four things that how do we know if we've already made this transition across the dimensional bridge? There are four major signs that are in the 5D world. The first is that you are able to completely detach from what is happening in the world. You may be interested in watching it, participating in the changes, but it no longer makes you upset to see the violence or hardship that others are experiencing. Detachment is all about the emotional distance. It is not pretending something is not happening, but instead it is about not permitting what is happening to affect you and your emotional state. Many others may view this as cold or uncaring, but in reality, by being in a state of detachment, this is your evidence that you no longer share your life with the energy of the 3D world. So this is my point. That's what I was just talking about. I talk about this frequently in our shows, is don't get caught up in what's going on out there. Keep your focus and your intent on yourself, doing your clearing work, and getting the clarity to understand and feel and through intuition, bring through the information you need in your particular reality and world, your inner world, that will clear your indwelling soul, literally, of the block and the amnesia that's been imposed on us. I've been working directly with people in their souls, helping them to clear the blocks in their souls, to bring back clarity and increased memory of who we really are. And it's just astounding what's happening. The second thing, this incidentally what I'm quoting here, I'll give this to you so you can look at it. This is Karen Downing, update on the ascension process. And that's where you can find it on the internet. Karen Downing, update on the ascension process. It's in the Spirit Library, October 24th, 2013. There's a lot of good information there besides what I'm giving you now. The second thing that we'll find, and this is amazing, this has been happening to me lately, you find yourself to be invisible to others. Now, she's talking about after you get into the ascension process. This can be physical invisibility when out running errands, driving, or interacting in public spaces where people very nearly run into you. And I've had this happen in the last week, two really close accidents where people just didn't see my car, and if I hadn't been alert, I'd have been nailed. Well, or possibly not, who knows. Don't worry, your guides will be there to prevent an actual collision. This is because your entire body system is vibrating at a much higher rate than those in the same space, and therefore they cannot see you until you're very, very near to them. Another form of invisibility is the emotional distance that can grow between you and the people who were once close to you. If you find it more and more difficult to contact others because they make you feel drained, tired, or if you simply find they are no longer understand your life, then this is your evidence of emotional invisibility. And that's another thing that I've said repeatedly. We have to let go. Let go. Let go. Release friends and family and physical things and allow ourselves to move into these higher frequency ranges, out of the third dimension, into the fourth dimension. So everything I've been doing for the last 2 years on this radio show and even prior to that fits right in what we're talking about here. Okay, thirdly, your manifestation abilities become heightened. Your evidences of this is things showing up right when you need them, but not necessarily sooner. It is about being in a truly receptive state where you are guided entirely by your intuition to bring you right to where and when you need to be. This is when people around you will keep telling you how lucky and blessed you are, but you understand that everyone is blessed. If only each person could recognize that within themselves. This takes place because you are at one with your needs, and the influence of the ego, which comes up with the manifestation process, has been neutralized. And that happens to me too. I never worry about whether the bills are going to be paid at the end of the month, because it's always just there. Enough people call and get appointments. Incidentally, I need some appointments this month from anyone out there who's willing to, or who think they need my work, to call up and help me through this period of drought that I'm in right now. But it'll happen, and we'll talk more about that later. But I think you all realize that as you raise in this frequency range, you become the co-creators, and the law of attraction begins to work for you. Remember the George Green's four laws? The law of attraction is the very first one, that you attract what you need. You attract what you express and are, and that certainly works out here. As we're working towards this ascension of consciousness, which we can begin to call it now, the understanding of where we're really going at this, which I've been calling just moving into the fourth dimension, but it's much more than that. This is what allows it to work. Is at number one, clarity. I can never say clarity enough. Getting yourself clear and released of the patterns and forms that hold you in form, and the karmic stuff. The karmic stuff is big time. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Let's see, the third thing, your manifestation abilities become heightened. Your evidence of this is things showing up right before when you need them. Well, I guess we just read that one. Finally, let's see, she says, you feel a peace that passes all understanding, a peace that inhabits every cell in your body, a feeling of peace with all that is, was, and will be. You have transcended the influence of the ego. And for me, that's the domination force that's within us. It still exists. It still talks to you, but you no longer listen to it. It will have been neutralized because you will have worked through your past life inventory of patterns. That says it all right there. We have to spend as much time as we possibly can meditating, go within, reading my book, Clearing the Way to Higher Consciousness, and using that, because it's a prototype to teach you how to do that inner work and access and clearing and whatnot. Emotions and beliefs. Because if you do not address the past life release, portions of the ascension process if you do not address the past life release portion of the ascension process, then you are leaving within your essence ammunition for the ego to use against you. As long as this ammunition exists, you'll not be able to transcend the ego's influence. Once you reach the stage of peace, you are in what is known as universal consciousness, which is the state of being in 5D. And that just says so well what we've been doing and what we've been working towards all the time and didn't realize it. Would the rest of you agree to that? Catherine, what's your take on this?
I am so happy that everybody knows and are hearing and are working towards what I know we are all capable of doing. And it is fabulous, Frank. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody, for allowing and being and striving for the ascension of all, because it is glorious. Thank you.
And that's one who did come back in to help us. We have absolute validation of that. Susan, what's your intake input on this? Is this where you
But I'm just trying to think here for a minute, because I was, like a lot of times here, I just get, I hear what people are saying and then I integrate it and, I've been definitely feeling all the, as sensitive as I am, I've been feeling everything, what's going on here, but it's just like everybody else is called, I'm here for a reason, and I chose this, and I just think it's just wonderful, actually, what we're doing. I couldn't be more pleased with what's going on, and
Well, we can be pleased that it's happening. It's right before our very eyes, and it's happening within us, and we're coming to full realization of what's happening now, too.
Yeah.
JP, what's your take on this?
Of course, I was standing in the kitchen. My takeaway is I've been sitting in this chair for the last 5 hours. I just needed to get up. Anyway, so where were we?
Well, we're just getting feedback from the group as to what we've been doing in our preparation for the ascension process without really understanding where we were going with it, but just being prompted and literally led into this.
Well, I've had several thoughts this week. One of them, and that kind of relates to a lot of people here who've got computer problems. And say you had a Windows computer, like a lot of us have, most of us have probably, and it gets a virus, and you're using it, and it gradually degrades in its working, and there comes a point when actually you just have to reinstall the system, but there's a way to get the data off it, but you have to run the system, and you have to dive in, get the data, copy it onto a memory, hard drive or something like that, and then you wipe the system. Okay, so that's what you do when a Windows system is gone beyond. You save the data. What I believe is that our soul function, our soul lineage and everything like that is the data. And that our timeline is like a Windows computer that is just far too corrupt, and we're being saved onto a hard drive, as it were, and reinstalled onto another hard drive where on a clean system. Does that kind of concur with the feeling, or am I talking completely?
Oh, absolutely. We're rewriting the script here, aren't we? The hardware. We've got the hardware. We're rewriting the operating system. And there's one of us in this group that has really been getting a lot of downloading recently, and it's making incredible changes in her life. Rachel, could you share with us a little bit about what's happened with you and what the realizations are that are coming to you?
I'm getting very heavy downloads. I know that one day that I worked with you, Frank, there was new types of codes coming in. The galactic sounds will come through the Skype, but this time it was different. And I can feel all these like symbols and codes and lights, and they come in, and it's a guy just talking about it, I get goosebumps, and it somehow is working with me and my sales, and I literally get put out. I've got to sleep, and it's taking me out to, I believe, to these portals. And I feel like I'm going out to the solar system, to the galactic. And even today, I was feeling another download, and I open my eyes, and the doorway literally opens up into a portal, and it's alive. But I've been also shown, it's like what you just shared about the universal consciousness, that so much of this work I've done with you, I keep feel like I'm clearing, that I was even shown in a dream that I've reached unity consciousness. Mm-hmm. And I was like in this school. And so it's like there's a part of me, I'm so grateful for all these steps I've had to take, and some of it has been hellacious and challenging, and yet now I can really see the bigger picture of why I had to go through all of these things, and it was all an act of love. And we're moving into this new space that is so incredible. I'm so excited, and some of the things that Kim Marie was speaking of, I can really feel like we're moving into this new realm of things. And all I can say is some of it I can't bring back. I feel like I'm opening up to that, but I get these heavy downloads. And how I'm dealing with it is I have to go lay down and rest.
Yeah, it's never lost. What they're downloading is things that come back up intuitively to you, because I think the same thing happens to me a couple or three times a week. I go through these downloads, but that's immediately something new will appear, some new perception, some new ideas, some realizations, and it's exactly what you need to take the next step. And it's happening all over the world. Incidentally, I want to introduce our newest member. This is Yvonne Murphy from New Zealand. And welcome, Yvonne. Do you have your mic on?
Yeah, I just turned my mic on. Thank you so much, Frank.
Hello there.
Pleasure and privilege to join you all. Thank you so much.
Well, the reason I mentioned Yvonne is that she's one of these people that has gone through hellacious things in her life, which we won't share because there's no need to that. But I've noticed how Crystal talked about, Kimmy talked about some portals being put on Earth that came in particularly to do certain things. And it seems like the opposition force is excessive on these people, just to hold them down and keep them back. But ever so often, I find these people and help get them clarity and get them understanding of why they had to go through all the crap they did, and make it a teaching experience for them, so they can download the positive aspects of who they've become and not be filled with what they were. And this is what I experienced with Yvonne. And I'm going to share with you now one of the things. It's okay to share your Catholic experience, isn't it, Yvonne?
Yes, of course. Share anything. Thank you.
Okay. This beautiful soul was raised in a Catholic family and went through all kinds of real negative stuff in her childhood and lifetime. And, of course, there was always a conflict with the church all the way through there, and the program that it inflicted on her and everything. And so in our first session, we cleared as much as we could out of this lifetime. But in the second session, when I went back and did a reading on her this week, there was just a dark cloud hanging on her. And I looked and looked and looked, and for something in this lifetime that would relate to it. And then it suddenly hit me. This cloud was the karma of the Catholic Church, that she had, in many past lives, been involved with the church, not as a dominator, but as a participator, as a strong supporter, by being a nun and a priest, and the workhorses of the church, who are expected to give their all and literally get paid nothing for it except the good graces of the gods, which is not necessarily Christ, but the church itself, the organization. And what I realized is that these folks who give their personal power away that way and don't come into self-realization time, it becomes a personal karmic block on them that really holds them from ever finding themselves until it's cleared out of their system. And so it's like taking on, because they so gave their power away to the organization that they became a part of it in the things that on those levels dominated others around them and kept others informed. It sounds like a weird thing, but that's exactly what happens. And this is what comes through to me so strongly after working with Yvonne, is the realization that we have to go back and clear or bring an energy balance to everyone, even in past lives, who every organization, every teacher, whatever, that has contributed to what we our self-perception is in this lifetime. By clearing that, by going back and letting go of that, and the responsibility for that, and the karma for that, for helping it create the darn thing, then it frees you up to be who you really are. That brought me to the realization that in this lifetime, I got to thinking about it now. Someone as beautiful as Yvonne is, she's a psychiatrist that works with abused children and things of that nature. She's really a giver. And yet she has had some difficulty in receiving, being able to receive or to attract enough to care for her needs. And I know a lot of good people have that problem. We've been programmed to be poor. And if we have any excess, we're to give it away, because as long as the church kept us poor and in domination, we couldn't grow beyond it. See, that was one of the really negative patterns. So I looked at this, and the realization came that when someone, this goes outside of the church now and that stuff, this is to any teacher, any source of information or enlightenment that comes to you, if you're just a taker and you take energy from that teacher or healer or a doctor or anyone without giving back to them, then you're draining that person of energy. I know the energy seems like it's inexhaustible that comes through me as I give, and it is. But think of how much more they would have if you gave energy back to in balance. So you're a strong supporting field out there, supporting your teacher, your caretaker, your guide, your nurturer, whoever it is that gives to you. And even if you give nothing but thanks and gratitude, thanks and gratitude, if given with a force of energy, balances the karma. Because if you're just takers, becomes a karmic flow. But if you distribute it to others or give it back in gratitude, then that balances and brings harmony back into it. And this is particularly when you're working with teachers who need your financial support too, to keep them going. If he's take and don't give it back to them, they're soon going to have to go out and get a job, and they can't do their thing for you anymore. So this giving back, nurturing your nurturer is important. I'd like to throw that out to the group for this discussion. Catherine, what do you think of that?
Well, it is very, very important. For instance, I'll give you is years ago when we first started our prayer groups to where we would heal or go and work with earthquake grid and do different things. If I didn't feel strong enough to do it on my own, I would send you energy or the group energy so that you could utilize my energy so I didn't have to be present. I don't know if that makes sense or not. Sending grace and forgiveness and gratitude and peace and love is always a way to instill energy in somebody or to grant them. It's almost like, say, if you had a fairy wand, and if you say thank you to somebody, and you're hitting their chakra system, and that's giving them energy and so forth. And it is very, very important, always important.
Well,
Catherine, you were amplifying your energy for the use of the group. Does that make any sense?
Yes, it does.
I know our primitive ancestors understood that principle because they wouldn't take from nature without giving something back. You know, even if it was just a pinch of tobacco or something from their heart, that the heart energy and energetically giving back to nature always assured them that nature would give back to them and equaled whatever their needs were. Domination, on the other hand, the main precept there is take and give back as little as you possibly can or have to. And see what's happened? It's created a horrible force of negative consciousness here in the world.
Well, here's another example, Frank. Say if you're out to dinner and the waitress or waiter, if you are demanding and mean and dominating, you know, they're just dead at the end of their shift. But if you are thankful and grateful for everything that they do and bring to you, their energy just picks up to where they go even overboard to give you better service.
That's true.
I remember when I was doing massage work, I could manipulate the energy in the room, and it was good. I enjoyed it. You could pull the best out of anyone.
Does anyone else have any ideas along this line?
Yeah, Frank, it's Yvonne. My experience is that in truth, I can only ever give to myself. And so, you know, whenever it seemed that I've given to ones, you know, in more need than me, for example, the winters that I've spent in India, and I work with some village children and people there, you know, what's given back indirectly is so much bigger than I could even ever imagine. You know, the grace and the growth and the abundance that comes, not directly, but very, very quickly. It just makes me so humble and so, you know, in awe of the mystery and how it works. And I see clearly then that I can only ever give to myself, and I want to remember that. Thank you.
You are a living light, Yvonne, that I encounter occasionally in people. And usually the people that are the living lights don't realize it. They don't understand how important they are, how they affect everyone around them simply by their presence. And as I work with them, or as they work with themselves, literally, to get clarity, so that light source that they are just comes out in an unrestricted flow, they affect the change of the world. That's all there is to it. And this is what Kimmy is talking about, the people around who are ready to recognize that they are living lights and what they have to give, and to be channels for that galactic energy that comes through. And speaking of energy, I would like to share something with you about the photon belt that we learned in the last couple of weeks. I was curious about the photon belt, so I opened up to it to see if I could feel it. And a most amazing thing happened, and I'd like to share this with you now. And so we're going to do a little meditation. So get in your meditative state of mind, receptive, and just close your eyes. Take your awareness up into your forehead and move right straight back in your head now. Initially just feeling for any stress or anything that's in your system. You feel any tightness on the way back to the subconscious mind, anywhere, any fullness, just push it out all the way back to the spine. And now we're not going to step out into the subtle energy field. We're going to stay in the physical on this one. Now take your awareness down your spine and anywhere, any chakra, anywhere where you feel any tightness. If somebody in this group's got a real tightness in your throat, it might be a healing situation to work with later. Some stress, let that go. Take your awareness all the way down until you feel open down to the zero point. And then on down the spine to the root chakra. Now, you're aware of the clearing the way process, that when you put your mind and your focus and your attention on something, that's really your soul attention. And when you put your mind on a subject, you can feel it in your body, wherever it's stored in your system. So now we have the awareness that the photon belt has incredible light force energy in it. And it's not been defined what that is, other than the fact that it's really another form of unconditional love that you get from the galactic center. This is more of a physical energy. This works right directly in the physical systems, where the galactic energy kind of works with the higher ranges, realms of consciousness. So I'd like to have you just settle back with your attention deep within yourself. Go into your soul center and then open up your frontal lobes and reach right straight out, reaching outward, upward to the photon belt. And just make yourself a hollow vase, a vessel, and let that energy pour in through your third eye. Any resistance you feel, just push them aside. And it's just like a physical force that enters into you. Bring that physical force down to the back of the brain, down the spine to the zero point. Now we already have the realization, one of the things this does, this force of consciousness does, it clears karma. So in the zero point, once you drop down into the low self now, take this energy in a reverse flow down through the zero point with the intent to clear karma. Feel it drop right down into your low self. The denseness of it is what's so impressive, because there's so much power here. Right down, subconscious, we desire to clear any karmic attachments we have in this lifetime or past lifetimes, particularly any karmic attachments having to do with the Catholic Church or any master that we gave our power to and inadvertently became a part of their domination. Photon flow, thank you. I feel incredible shifts occurring right now in this group and everyone listening out in the radio audience. We're particularly focused on clearing the religious programming that made us, through error, participate in domination, or any financial programs, or educational programs, any civil programs, where we participated in the domination of others, even though we thought we were doing it with right choice and good grace of mind when we did it. Now, galactic flow, you're doing a wonderful job. We want to take you down into Earth Mind and clear our own Akashic records. Clear the Akashic records held in Earth Mind, our instinctive consciousness of all the things we did to dominate others in any form, at any time, all the wrong choices, all the way back through our genetic history, back to the very beginning of Homo sapiens, 400, 380,000 years ago. And we follow the genetic flow to do this. Through the power of the Christ consciousness within us, we release the third dimension and all the third dimensional activities we participated in that cause lack or fear or domination or in any way restricted others in free thinking. Let the flow keep on pouring through you. Make sure it touches every cell in your body. All right, subconscious, we clear our DNA. Our DNA in every cell in our body from the domination patterns implanted there by the Anunnaki, or any other species of alien who meddled with our genes at any time in our procession and our growth of consciousness as human beings. We clear now, we bring back the pure and perfect state of the God Force consciousness in human beings, even going beyond the Anunnaki and their domination. We go beyond that, back to source, go back to the true God source, working with the photon energies and with the galactic flow of energy coming into us now, making our hands tingle. We bring the Christ consciousness back into our understanding and our state of being. We are human beings. We are God Force beings becoming. We clear all ego that would prompt us to dominate or control or be mean in any way to anyone else. And this is what I see the galactic force, the photon force as being, as the ultimate tool we've been waiting for to gain clarity in our bodies so we can easily transcend through the fourth dimension and into the fifth dimension. And as we progress along and raise our consciousness, we'll understand what's happening and can look forward to how to do and participate in ascension. Through the power of the Christ within us, we thank all of you who assist us. We accept our healing, our clarity, and we acknowledge who we really are. Our indwelling soul is opening up now that we have clarity, regaining soul memory, and we'll work as a unified force to clear and release the domination force from the earth. And so it is. Okay, JP, let's take a break now, and we'll come back and use this new power for some healing work.
Five and a half minutes. Thank you.
Okay, we're back. JP?
Yes, we are indeed. Exactly, you said it exactly when we came on. I thought, well done, Frank.
Well, let's review a little bit about what happened in this last hour. We came into self-realization, number one, of what we're here for and what to do and what's going to be coming to us in the future. Number two, we've just gained an incredible tool to get, to work with our clarity or clearing processes. And was there any of you who did not feel that flow come through you, that incredible clearing, cleansing, healing flow? I'm talking to my group now.
Well, Frank,
very
yeah.
Intense.
I'll jump in and share, Frank, because this is one of the times that I did not, and probably for good reason, as I was sitting there looking and watching for the energy to come through the third eye. I caught actually opposition force energies attempting to come in. And if you can get this visual, it's like watching a rubber band expand, trying to come in the third eye. And it was basically pushed back out and would not come in. It simply mm-hmm. could not gain access.
Mm-hmm.
So that was fine. I missed the meditation, but I caught and stopped.
Well, thank you, David, for that feedback, which comes as a warning to us to be cautious in working with any energy flows coming in and ascertain through dowsing or through your own inner knowing if it's positive or negative, because the opposition force is really going to get after us big time now since we're working with this kind of power. So thank you, David. That's really appreciated. Yeah. Incidentally, David is one of those ascended masters who came back in to do powerful work, and he's been in, under incredible opposition, and we've been working with it, and he will get there, is
yep.
there.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Well, that's what I would like to say, thank you to David also, because what you did there was for all of us, so thank you very much for doing it for us all. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Sure.
Well, he has experienced the flow before in a private session, and so he knows how to work with it.
Yep, I do it myself and use it just about daily now, and it is very intense and quite beautiful.
All right. So where do we go from here? That's always the next question. The first thing we do is continue our own clearing work. You can't do enough. And there's always the opposition force will find some way to sneak around you, like they just did with David, and try to come in the back door on you. So be aware, because your challenges are going to come up now. And this is what happens when we go through the neck of the bottle. You've heard me talk about going from one level of experientiality to another. As you go up through the neck of that bottle into the next level, you're immediately met by the opposition force. They try to discourage you or knock you down and take you out. But if you can overcome it with what you've learned in the lower levels, use your what you've learned as much as you know, you can defeat it on any level and continue to expand on out. Accumulate everything you can, then bring that back in and internalize it, and you go up to the next level. This is how it works. That's the ascension process. You don't just sit back on your butt and say, hey, I'm wonderful, so fix me and make me wonderful, somebody. You do it yourself, and no one can do it for you. We can share, we can teach, we can give understanding and revelation, but ultimately it comes down to each individual, because we are all like our own little unique solar system, each one of us has our own array of planets within ourselves that need to be dealt with and understood.
And don't be fearful. Do not be fearful, because your biggest allies in this is laughter and love.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever anything comes at you, you know, if you don't know what to do, laughter and love, laughter and love.
And now you are becoming ambassadors of the ascension process. Once you learn how to do this and have the clarity and confidence that you can talk to others about it, showing them these three simple things one clarity, how to access the subconscious mind and how that works and all the levels of that. Number two, accessing the galactic flow. So that is here giving you guidance from higher levels of consciousness. And number three, working with the photon flow. So it can come in and give you the energy and the power to do it. Because that's what I see happening here. We've got more power than we've ever had access to before. And now we can drop down into the low self and earth mind and deprogram and clear all that stuff that holds us in form. Any comments on that? How do you see that, Kimri? Do you, this is the approach?
Well, we are definitely here. We've been called here. I know a lot of us feel like we've been summoned and we've been holding this sacred fire for quite some time. I definitely am in pure alignment with all the work that you've been doing over the years. And, you know, I've actually been reading some of your books too lately, Frank. So it's interesting how the information is coming in now at such a time when we actually can hear it, integrate it, use it as the tools that we, you know, who knew? The photon belt. I mean, this is exactly why the message that the Mayans delivered as we walked across Turtle Island, all these sacred spots, their message simply was no fear.
Mm-hmm.
And just like someone else mentioned, laughter and love, if you don't know what to do, love and laugh. And honestly, we already have everything we need to be able to get through this last piece. We know we already have it. It's all innate. It's all innate within us. We just got to remember.
And don't forget to give back to the source or to your teachers or whatever source information comes from. Give back energy and gratitude or thanks or money is energy, you know. That should demonstrate your gratitude. And it does support your teachers. So please keep the cycle flowing. Okay, are there any more comments about this?
Hi, everyone. This is Teresa. I was this weekend at a gem show in a city nearby in southern Ontario, and I was working with the Canadian Society of Dowsers, and there were so many people that came up and to me, you know, after I taught them a little mini pendulum teaching, and just immediately these portals opened where of conversation where there were people who were drawn to me to share this type of work. And I hope, and I've introduced a lot of them to Universal Mind Radio, and a great shout out to all of those who are, in addition to who normally listen in, to those wonderful people in Southern Ontario who were so hungry to hear what I had to share about the work that we're doing. And I'm so excited. I was just bubbling over and talk about exchanging energy. As I was sharing the information with these people, I just got so excited, and I feel so passionate about it. And you could just see them lighting up. Their eyes were just lighting up. And the energy that came back, it was like, it was just a perfect, it was like a yin-yang. It just went back and forth, the energy. And it was so lovely, and it was so lovely to be able to share and to offer to people who were hungry the feast that's in front of them of clarity and how to do it. And I've worked with quite a few people on my breaks, and when my time was, I put in my volunteer time to help clear people who were desperate to have that. And crossing souls over, and some pretty dark entities, and I reached out to everyone here, to all of you, for that support, for protection, and it was so exciting to be able to be with people who were, it almost felt like they were hanging on a raft, you know, like they were in fear. They didn't know how to deal with a lot of stuff, but they knew there was somebody out there, including people who, you know, like if spirits come to them that frighten them, I say, oh, that's good. They've come to you. So because you know somebody who knows somebody and who knows somebody who can help. And I can help you. Universal Mind Radio team can help you. And it was so beautiful to have that offering to share. And it was, again, it was like that portal was wide open. And I felt like, oh, this is so great. And I'm so grateful to everyone here, as everyone in this group has opened their hearts to me, in particular Grand Poobah Frank, Francis, and Stephen. I am oh so grateful. And that's all I'd like to share this evening.
Oh, that was beautiful. Thank you for sharing that, Teresa. And you are an ambassador of ascension, for ascension. And so that's what we can call ourselves. All right, any other comments?
Well, there's a question that came in from the chat room there, Frank. This is from Free Sovereign. How do we get the entire world to exit the money game and the taxation game? And I would also add to that the authority game.
Well, I already see now, just on the strength of what we accomplished tonight, with everyone being able to download and receive this energy, and I do want to welcome everyone out in the listening audience and everyone you Ascension Ambassadors speak to. Please demonstrate to them, show them these energy flows that you can bring in, and let them feel these in their bodies, and do work with them. Teach them how to do clearing work, and get the information necessary so that you know what you're doing when you talk to them. And this is how we'll do it. It's one person at a time. One person at a time. But everyone knows everyone else. So in 6 months' time, we can have the entire world in ascension here.
Well, Frank, I have a feeling if some of us were to contact you individually, you might be able to help us through this. How do I reach you?
Well, as always, through psytronics.com. That's our website, psi-tronics.com. It means mind power, psytronics.
And I imagine if I were to just call you, would you set up an appointment, or can you help me then? Or
I prefer to have, if possible, emails, but calls are fine too. The email is fljordan@cableone.net. fljordan@cableone.net, cableone.net. Phone number is 208-344-9188. 208-344-9188. All right, shall we dive into some healing?
Wow, what a week. I've felt really quite intense energies this week, you know, up and down, black and white, blue and red, an extreme kind of, a bit like, you know, I'm in a very small boat and the sea is choppy.
Well, that's why I was asking about your stress level and if there's anything we could do to help you in that regard. And we will certainly do that. And
well, of course, you know, getting paid for the work that I've done, that will help.
Yeah.
getting some, you know, having finance financial support always helps. So, I mean, but that's everybody. I don't mind doing work, but I don't like working for chicken feed. I actually did a job for chicken feed, to exchange to feed my chickens, and, there was a bad experience as well. So anyway, let's help.
Tell us how to contribute to you.
Well, you can go to Ever Beyond Radio and, click the donate button. You can download any of the archives. You can purchase things. I make things, and they're all on my website, and you can buy them by PayPal or credit card. Obviously, it would be a bit silly to buy really big things because, you know, the exorbitant price of sending them across to the States. But there are things that I can send, and there are things that I can do as a, you know, I'm very, very happy to do private consultation work and things like that. So, yeah, just Ever Beyond Radio, get in touch. You know, just find it on there, everbeyondradio.com.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
And Gary, what can we do to help you since you're doing our sponsorship work here now?
Just keep on doing what you're doing. Everybody's doing the right thing already pretty well. The money thing is not a problem for me at this time, so I don't worry about that. So we can
send you lots of blessings and love.
Yeah. Promote the Universal Mind Radio.
Okay, let's look at the more practical things here. Jackie's requesting a healing tonight for Rick Chambers of Bend, Oregon. 60 years old, has an aorta hernia. Right leg artery is 78% blocked, left leg 68%. Is having surgery on October 9th. Wonder why in the world they're waiting so long to get to him. That's ridiculous.
I don't know why, Frank. And he's been having this problem for several years. I guess it just finally got to the point where he better do something fairly quickly. He's having trouble walking even.
Yeah. This is what causes blood clots to come up and hit the heart. And that's the lungs. And that's the end of that.
Yeah.
All right, now, we have to be careful how we approach this. We can't just blunder in and throw a lot of energy and do something that's going to cause a problem for him.
Right.
So we ask. We're listening now. All right, what they're showing me is what we should ask for is a general revitalization of his arteries and veins so they're capable of carrying the flow of blood again, and in such a manner that it'll be a slow transition process back into full function stability in a way that doesn't break loose some arteries and cause any problems. So what we do, we're going to take Rick back in time. Rick, I hope you're listening. I want you to just take your awareness up into your forehead, step right straight back into your indwelling soul, all the way back now, all the way back till you feel yourself expand in the subtle energy field, and drop your awareness down to your heart center, and we're all one with you in this. And then drop your awareness down into Earth Mind, to below your feet. So we're unifying the Oversoul and the Undersoul and the zero point in the mid-range of consciousness that holds the reality, actually the physical standing wave that is your reality. And we're going to go back in time now. Take yourself back 20 years. Back where you're a young, healthy, vital man, blood flowing well. And we're going to bring in back into your cellular consciousness by carrying that visualization, that reality forward to this point of now in the zero point, and any conditions that affected you or any situations or anything you did to your system, like smoking or that caused hardening of the arteries or plaque or breakdown of the system, we're bringing the perfection back into that so your system will shift naturally and easily. And we're clearing that system out of the standing waves, the negativity right up to this moment of now in the zero point. So keep our attention on the past, healing the past. We have to heal it all the way back in the past. Now, through the power of the Christ within us, in the zero point, we see Rick Chambers in the perfect and normal condition, and we carry that forward in time, project that into his future as a healthy and vital person. We see your legs coming back into full circulation in the pure and perfect order. So there's no chance of you having an inadvertent blood clot. Through the power of the Christ within us, we see Rick in a perfect and normal condition. We see the aortic hernia being corrected. We're wrapping a strong energy field around that. So that it does not rupture and cause instant death. And that'll, can even repair that to where the doctor don't even have to operate on him. I've done this before. Okay. Now we're bringing in, use our new tools here. The galactic flow is working with us. They're showing us what to do. That's what that the tingling is in your fingers, everyone out there. And everyone out there who is working on somebody that you know that has a similar condition or blood vessel problems. We can all heal them at once right now by doing this. That tingle in your fingers is the galactic flow bringing through the perfection, the template from the oversoul that's working with the undersoul to supply the physical reality of what we need, the mother, the female polarity. Now we want to bring in the galactic flow. This is something new for us, not the galactic flow, the photon flow. So open the front of your heads now. Feel the photon flow come in to the zero point and work directly in the reconstruction of Rick's body. There, we're opening up a new channel. This has not been done before. Okay, that's interesting. You're bringing in specific light energy now to help complete this work.
I see tiny multicolored strands of energy. Is that what you're talking about?
That's it. That's exactly what they are.
Like kind of, you know, little thin threads all in different colors.
Exactly. And each one of those is a frequency of energy. How interesting. I feel it working in his heart as much as anywhere. That
I see a huge vortex pouring into his heart like a funnel.
Yeah, he's had heart problems, which caused that poor circulation, caused the breakdown in his legs.
But I also see him laughing and giggling, like this stuff is kind of like a kind of happy tickle.
Jackie, do you know if he's listening?
No, I don't know, Frank. We're hoping he's listening. We asked him to.
All right.
But he'll definitely be listening to the replay of this, believe me.
All right. Well, it's working right now. And it can, the greater clarity that he has and the more he accepts it, the better it'll work. Okay, so we close to Rick now and wrap him in an energy field that will continue working. Jackie also has healing for Jade from Chehalis, Washington, 65. His 8th and 9th vertebrae were injured in a fall 3 years ago. Is that up in the middle of his thoracic vertebrae?
Yes, thoracic,
Okay, it'll be about between his shoulder blades, right?
Yes.
All right, we're putting our hand in Jane, her left hand is inside his body, right hand outside. And we're just letting the galactic flow come through now and see where he's got a lot of bone buildup there, calcification. We're dissolving that calcification and moving the vertebrae back into proper alignment. And I want to bring in the photon flow to provide a lot of physical remanifestation of the bone. And you see the discs rebuilding. See the power of the Christ within us. We see James from Chehalis, Washington, straightening his back, that bad kink there, through the power of the Christ within us. See this back in the perfect and normal condition. Okay. Now I wrap an energy field around that to continue building the discs and to calm, to heal the injured nerves. Okay, very good. And so it is. I wrap a field around the whole thing. As long as we're on backs, I want to go to Marie MacArthur in British Columbia. We worked last week on her lower back. I want to reinforce that her lumbar vertebrae that were collapsing. Through the power of the Christ within us, we see Marie in the perfect and normal condition. I had another session with her, incidentally, and she said she's doing very well. Seeing the nerves all cleared out, it was causing the problems of her intestines. All right. This is a reminder to all of you people out there listening. If you know someone who has a similar problem or any kind of a problem you want to direct this energy to, you simply put them between your hands and let the energy flow through, and it will. You'll know you got it when you get almost a blazing energy coming out of your hands. What that is left hand is negative polarity for the female principle of Earth. And the right hand is the male energy of the male principle, which is the higher levels of consciousness that hold the form, and they come together in the zero point to manifest in this moment of now. We can correct anything in the past that is in error and take it into the futures. Okay. And the healing will directly be related to how well you believe it, how well you want to be healed, how much you want to be healed. Do you have any vested interest in hanging on to your injury, like a welfare check or something like that? And number four, there's a spiritual lesson in every one of these healings. Every healing I ever did in the last 35 years was a spiritual event, because people just go away feeling different and having a better understanding. And so this is true spirituality. This is not the pseudo-spirituality that you'll get in churches or anywhere else. Okay. I got to get on my soapbox there for a moment. Now, what do we have?
Frank, this is Dent.
Sure.
I have some people here in Bend that need healing. Is it all right if I talk about them now?
Absolutely.
I have a person, his name is Friend, as in my friend, your friend, that's his real name. He is, he lives in Eugene, Oregon, and he's 37 years old, and he has MRSA, which is that terrible staph infection you get from having operations, an operation on his knee and his leg. He had knee surgery prior to getting this MRSA, and then he had complications, had to go back for another surgery. He's having problems with his hands and feet, and his face with swelling. He's working long hours, caring for his daughter and wife who was fighting cancer. And he's in dire need of having this MRSA. He has an infection in his knee now that isn't going away.
Okay, did we work on him last week?
No, we didn't. We worked on a person, Buzzard. A similar, from the same family.
Okay. What is his name again?
Friend.
Friend, okay. All right, Friend. I hope you're listening now. We're going to tune in and do some clearing work on you. And you healers out there and listening audience, always clear the person of negative energies or attachments before you do the healing. Not simply do that with desire and will and intent, opening a torus outside of yourself and outside of them, and just willing any negative attachment into that torus to take it back to its own right and proper place. And it has to go. It cannot be there except by your permission. And so clear it out. Okay, Friend, close. All right, Friend, you've got an interesting situation here. It's almost like you're allergic to life. Everything's attacking you out there, and it's an interesting situation that your wife has cancer also. So what I want to do with the group, we're going to put this family in an orb between our hands. Put your hands about 8 inches apart. Rub them once if you want. Get this energy polarity field growing, and we visualize an orb, an energy orb, and we put Friend and his wife both in this orb, and their entire situation in life, whatever the creative factors are, we're seeing them in this orb. We're seeing the power of the Christ within us. is working through this orb, through their auras, their systems, their life, their reality, their family, their home, absolutely clearing the mental emotional causes, helping them to come up and clear their financial and emotional problems. Whoa. Okay. Through the power of the Christ, and as we see friend and his wife and family in the perfect and normal condition. Now I want to bring in the galactic flow and open friend up and the family. Let the flow move directly into them now. We do that by opening their third eyes, letting them be vessels for the beautiful, incredible photon energy we just learned to work with tonight. Let that come into their systems, negating the cancer and the infections, bringing them back into the pure and perfect condition. Now, everyone in the audience, direct your globe directly to friend and his family at Bend, Oregon. Dent will direct it with his mind, is where to put it. Wow, that's good. They ought to feel like they're frying right now. Close, and so it is. And
that was a good one, Frank. Wow.
And we ask the galactic flow to continue to feed energy in, and the photon flow to continue their healing process. Yeah, that felt good. All right. New tools, guys.
Yeah.
Remember what we create in our minds. In our imagination becomes a reality in some dimension, and we're learning to blend those dimensions just like we do when we blend the orbs together and create the unified field of reality. We're working in the unified field. You mentioned that the other night, Catherine. I hadn't realized that, but that's exactly what we're doing, right?
Yes. And it's glorious.
Should I try for another one, Frank?
Sure.
The lady's name is Morningstar. She's part of the same family. She's 40 years old. She lives in Joseph, Oregon. She's been very unhealthy most of her life. Since about the age of 3, she has recurring sinus and head and lung problems that begin with colds. These are accompanied by sweat, migraines, and feeling like she's burning up. She has numbness and very low energy a lot of the time. She has severe GERD and back pain, and her legs and feet and hands swell.
Well, that should be enough right there for us to work with. We're going to create another orb now. We're experimenting, but we're practicing. Create another orb, all of you out there, with your hands, and put Morningstar in this. Does she have Native American blood in her?
Yes, she does.
Yeah, that's what I felt. So, Morningstar, we're going to help you now to make direct connection to your ancestors and to your tribal memory, your cellular memory of how to do healing just like this. Morningstar, you're in our orb. We're unifying your 3 orbs, your 3-dimensional orbs, into one unified field. We're bringing in the galactic flow through our hands. That's what the heat is in our hands. And we're bringing in the photon energy into you now through your third eye. Feel yourself just filling up now with life force and vitality. And Morningstar, I want you to release your life. This is like a near-death experience in that you're releasing everything that has ever happened in your life that blocked you from becoming the beautiful person you really are. And this goes all the way back to childhood and even into your ancestors, your parents, your family flows. We clear and release you now of the family flows, any negative self-perception or blocks. Through the power of the crisis in us, Morningstar, we see you for the beautiful God force being you really are. We see your 0 point stopping all the standing waves of negativity that were moving into your future in this moment of now. We're blocking all those and simply announcing that in your new reality, none of those standing waves exist, nothing in Earth Mind, your Akashic records that carry your patterns of the past. Nothing exists except your pure and perfect condition in this moment of now. And Morningstar, you have to accept this as being your right and your authority to have this healing and to establish your sovereignty so that you're free and independent, healthy and vital, productive. You don't have to depend on anyone else now to take care of you. You are free. You're freed up to be what you came in to do. And so it is. And we extend this globe to Morningstar and send those standing waves into her future. And so it is.
Thank you, friend. Thank you, Bruce.
Give us feedback on what's happening with these next time.
I will. There's one other, if that's okay.
Okay.
Her name is Faith, and she lives in Bend, Oregon. She has problems with her immune system from a prior reoccurring phenomena, recurring pneumonia that she's had off and on for years. She also has a staph infection from surgeries that have gone wrong. She has COPD. She has scarred lungs from valley fever, pulmonary HTTN, and severe ulcers, and stomach problems from prior surgeries. She has back and bone problems from suffered from lung problems since she was a child.
How old is she?
She's 62 years old.
All right. Many people get a vested interest in their illness. It becomes a reality if they've had these conditions long enough. And the subconscious accepts their reliance on their illness for support and nurturing and love. And so we're going to talk directly to this lady's subconscious mind now and her low self. You're fully capable of total healing in this body you're indwelling in, low soul. We're going to bring to you the energy now because you know how to create a beautiful, perfect condition for this lady, for you to live in, so you'll have a happy, productive life. So we put our hands on each side of her heart in the 0 point. And we send, we bring in the galactic flow that knows exactly what to do. We bring in the photon flow that has exactly the energy that's needed. Now low self, work with us in the 0 point to create the pure and perfect condition for this lady. Let her also visualize herself and back in time when she had a pure and perfect body. But I want to clear those mental emotional shocks I feel back there in her as a child. Clear those, release those, so she has good positive self-perception and good point and purpose and reason for living and having a long, happy life. Now we come forward to the 0 point. Hold her in the perfection that we see. Just filling up her body with energy and light and love. Love is the thing this woman needs most. So extend out to her family and those who would love and nurture her. Let them open up and learn the value of love also. And nurturing. So much nurturing is needed to this family. Through the power of the Christ within us, we see her in the perfect and normal condition. And we set her on her feet so she can walk strongly and perfectly forward into life now. And so it is. Okay.
It is. Thank you, Frank.
Did we get everybody?
Those are all I had. Thank you.
Thank you. My nephew, John Robert, 17, here in Staten, has strep throat that I can't seem to get a handle on.
Just before we go, can I just say, we're going to have to leave you in a few moments, in about a minute's time. So what I'll do is I'll wrap up the program and leave the call. And
okay.
Will you kind of continue and finish off all the requests that we've had so far, or should we leave until next week?
Let's see, do you have them listed here so I can see them?
They're all in the chat box, yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll just continue with this group. You just go ahead and wrap up, and then we'll do this work.
Thank you so much, Frank. Thank you, everybody. I feel kind of emotional tonight. I don't know why. Thank you very much. It's been beautiful.
Love you.
Love you, JP. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Good night.
Good night, JP.
Okay. Do you want to work on John Robert?
Yeah.
All right, folks, that was all the end of the show.
Catherine's nephew, John
hope
Robert.
You enjoyed it.
In
I have another show I've got to do on a different radio station.
I'm going to stimulate his immune system.
I have to go now, but I'll be back.
Right hand over his upper chest.
Show for Frank George.
Left
we'll
hand
on
his
Wednesday.
Back.
At 9 a.m. It'd be 9 to 10 a.m. where we do Earth Mind Healing.
Okay, John.
Okay, folks. Hope you enjoyed it. See you all next time.
John, I want you to let go of that feeling of evading your work responsibilities if you're sick. You may not have even done it this time, but at some time you did. The subconscious says, well, this is a good way to get out of doing things, so we clear you of that now. Really throat clearing up. We take the life force, reduce the life force to the bacteria, the virus. There's a specific frequency we can hit to do that. Rachel, we haven't called on you for some time. Your tones, would you like to knock that
okay
out with a good frequency?
Hi-ya!
That was perfect. Thank you. I think you just stopped a plague down there.
Very much so, Rachel. You did. You hit everybody down here who has this.
That's wonderful. I feel
the
better.
Ebola virus. Yeah.
Oh, we need to send you to Africa.
Okay, who's next? What do we got down here?
Let me read one.
Who?
Katie Galante, thyroid and cortisol deficiency in San Diego, California.
All right. Katie, one of her hands on your throat. Oh, yeah, I can feel it. Through the power of the crisis in us, we see this condition. Totally normal, the thyroid coming back into balance and harmony on both sides. Bring in photon energy to give it physical remanifestation. Okay, tell her about her thyroid, her iodine deficiency. All right. All right, and so it is. Close. Okay, who's next?
Okay, there's a request from Alvaro Portilla, Playa del Carmen in the Yucatan. He's 38 years old. He has nonstop coughing for a month. Not sure what is causing it.
Okay. That's interesting. I'm having trouble picking him up. Do you have him, Joan? Do you want to lead this one?
He's through the chat room, so no, I have no idea who he is.
He's a friend of JP's.
Oh, okay. All right, that helped. All right, here we got it. All right. All right. I feel like it's got an invasive condition in his lungs. Take him back in time where the lungs were perfect. Cellular consciousness, this is the pure natural condition we desire in these lungs. We want this invasive life form to release. We clear it. I'm going to create a vortex and just suck it all out of there. That is a severe inflammation. Interesting. They're showing me he may be from the old Mayan culture, and if so, I'm seeing a crystal in each side of his chest, and we're programming that crystal with the anti-agent, whatever it is that he needs to knock down that condition. This is a new concept that we can put implants, the crystal implants in people, and because that's the way his ancestors would have done it. You see the clarity of the crystals clearing the condition and bringing back into perfect and normal condition. No inflammation. No more coughing.
How perfect is that?
That's beautiful. That came directly from his ancestors.
Frank, could that be why conventional stuff wasn't working?
Could be exactly why.
Yeah. So it wasn't programmed, it couldn't accept, yeah.
Yeah. That's right.
There's one more. There's one more in the chat room. This is from Wolf Baby. Healing for Kevin Spence. Has a possible bowel obstruction. He lives in Forres, Scotland.
Okay, Wolf Baby. Kevin Spence. Possible bowel obstruction. Okay. All right. I've had good success with these two. All right. We locate it. There it is. Okay. Okay. Now all they have to worry about is how to stop the diarrhea. Okay, that should do it. Close. Wow, it's been an interesting evening, guys. We learned a lot, haven't we?
Thank you, Frank. Could I talk just one more minute?
Sure.
I'd like to request a healing for Jackie Rochelle. Jackie is suffering from joint pain throughout her whole body, almost from her heels and toes up to her shoulders and neck, and it's just causing her all kinds of suffering. And when she had cancer, they did exploratory surgery and they took out her lymph nodes on her right side. Is there any way we can regenerate those lymph nodes? Because that just causes her all kinds of difficulty and incredible suffering.
All right, Jackie. First thing we want to do is wrap you in a shield of love here. Everyone just wrap Jackie in love.
Jackie, say something so I can hear your voice.
Jackie.
That was good enough.
Are you with us, Jackie?
I'm sorry. Yes, I'm here. I just was having a moment.
That's all okay. Right. I just needed to hear your voice. So okay. Let me hear the joy in your voice.
Well, I do have joy. I'm just having an emotional minute here.
All right. What I want you to do is open your heart. Open your heart and let our love come in. How much we treasure you. And we see you, Jackie. We see you. Now let go. Just let go. All that would be arthritic stuff. Just let it go. Let our love just pour in and replace every joint condition in your body. Every bit of what used to be called rheumatism, let it go. We also see your nodes reforming in the left side of your body.
Right side.
Right side, actually.
Right side?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, she'll have a double load on the left side.
I can use all the lymph nodes I can get.
Okay. Now, open your third eye and let the photon energy come in. Just load up your system with perfection, primarily driving out any karmic things that you might have to keep you from perfection. Okay, Jackie, are you feeling better?
I can feel her heart growing. You know, it's like the Grinch stole Christmas, how his heart grew at the end of the movie. That's what I was feeling.
Den says my heart is the heart that ate New York City. I mean, it's so big. I don't know if it's good.
Well, you were a giver of your heart energy. You didn't ever learn how to receive.
So. Yeah, that's the problem.
Well, see, that's why it's getting bigger now, is because it's receiving all of the love from us, and you're allowing it to happen. That is the key, sweetheart. You are allowing it to happen. You're accepting it into yourself, and you're feeling that love course throughout your whole body. With every breath you take in, all the crystalline love. And as you exhale, all of the stress and strain. And you inhale the love. And you exhale all your stress and strain. And that is so, and it continues. And thank you very much for allowing and accepting.
Well, thank you, guys, and thanks, Dent, for bringing that up.
Well, thank you, Dent. We do have to help each other because, you know, we have to be in the best state we can be to help others.
Yes, it's so hard for me to see her suffer all the time.
Well, it's whenever we are in pain or discomfort or dis-ease that our whole heart and mind and soul can't be on what we need to do. And those are also the back doors of how unsavory things come into us, and that's how they attack, because it is weak. So we are here to help each other. So always ask.
Thank all of you so much.
Jackie, did that just flare up after we cleared that entity out of you a couple weeks ago?
You know, it comes and goes, Frank, and I don't know what's going on with my... It's like my arthritis is just...
It feels like an autoimmune deficiency to me.
Yeah,
they've been doing a lot of chemical spraying and so forth here, Jackie, and I know that it's all blowing east, so I know that you're getting it in bend.
Yeah, and my immune system needs some time to build up from all that chemo stuff, I guess. I thought it was better, but it, you know, I don't feel quite as well as I think I should.
Did you get the flow come through your third eye?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Work with that.
Okay.
How long ago was your chemo?
It's been 2.5 years.
Okay.
So I don't know. And the radiation. So, but the good news is I had a mammogram Monday and I'm all clear.
Oh, you had pictures of your tits. Huh?
Yeah.
That is wonderful news, Jackie.
Well, I read something when I was looking up that photon belt, and I think it's good general information. Here it is.
Inflammation. is what she has a lot of.
Photonic energy is the highest form of light that can manifest physically. It's the cleanup cycle. It works with the biology of your DNA and consciousness. We have a light body, so it is the highest form of light. And I also wanted to note that when I saw some images, remember that donut energy we were talking about, the figure eight, how energy actually moves mm-hmm. around? It is that type of, so it's going in and chain, you know, connecting with us and moving out. It's a big... It's still that same donut, infinity, never ending, and it's quite beautiful.
Mike, let's use this photon energy on you, as long as we're on the subject. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm all there.
Okay. You just get relaxed and take your awareness to your forehead and just open that portal there. And just think about the photon energy out there and just suck it in. It's so interesting how it comes in. It's just waiting to come help us work with us. And when it comes in, it's a very palpable force. Wow. Do you feel it, Mike?
Yep.
Good. All right. Drop it down into your low self and reconstruct everything down there.
I really feel when it comes into me that it just, like, sucks my feet down into the ground, the energy. And then it's like a Mobius strip of that donut-type energy that Marilyn was speaking of.
Mm-hmm.
Or more like a Mobius strip for me.
It's seeking grounding energy. That's why it comes all the way through us, not out our feet. And so we direct that with the galactic energy. And it's literally, we can just literally re-manifest things with these forces. Through the power of the Christ within us, we see Mike's bowel in a normal and perfect condition considering everything that's happened to it. See the condition dissipating away. The chemo doing its job and departing. That's interesting. I'm working in, Mike. I'm feeling the flow through, and I'm actually opening up some constrictions that limit the flow. There's one right down in your neck there. Open that up. There. Whoa, that's going right down to the condition now. That's interesting.
Yeah, it was like that block was thwarting the healing, the total healing.
I was leaving him.
It worked.
Aw, sweet dreams, Mike.
Thank you.
Yeah. Aw. We love you, Mike.
Mike, you are complete, because all you ever wanted was unconditional love from females, and now you got it.
Boy, there you go. There you go.
It's very true.
That resonates.
Boy, I feel what's happening down there now. That's amazing.
Have I told all of you that I love you today?
No, it has been 24 hours and not a word from you.
Oh, I love all of you. Thank you for being.
Well, back at you.
Yeah. I'll take it.
You better send me an email. I never know when I can depend on you.
Ha, ha.
But we can't have a session without having her say, I love you.
Right.
It's a given. But it still feels so nice to hear it. We know it, but it's nice to hear it.
Maybe we can hear it in person sometime, maybe in Idaho.
We're working on it.
Yeah, to date, we're going to do it.
Hey, we're still broadcasting on UMR.
Well, that's good.
Thanks, Jared.
I love all of them, too.
Yeah, we love them all.
Should I leave it on? Let her go?
Why not?
Okay, I just wanted you guys to be. I just wanted you guys to know that you know.
Okay. Thank you, Gary.
So now you can get really, really all shy and afraid to talk and stuff like that.
We were doing so good too, Gary.
Boy, that photon energy coming in the third eye, it's just
delicious.
A wow to me. I don't know. Yeah, delicious. It's just so, I would compare it to that light that I see sometimes when I'm trying to go to sleep and my eyes are closed and it comes from within. It's that same type of a brightness light.
Yes, I'm having that experience too, Catherine. And different tones too. I'm getting very strong tones. And there could be three different tones playing off each other.
Oh, that's even better, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And if you think about it, Rachel, that makes sense because we all have the Trinity within us, you know, the lower self, middle self, upper self, higher self. So, yeah.
Rachel, I wish we had a copy of the toning you just did. That was wonderful.
Oh.
So strong.
You do have a copy.
Yeah.
I was thinking
recorded.
You should do a CD of tones.
What she does is she picks up the basic tone of the life force, and then she raises it and changes it, and that changes the condition of the organism, and the organism can go on living, but it doesn't hurt anything anymore.
Wow, it's powerful.
Yeah, it is.
Well, I was actually thinking it wouldn't be that difficult if we had. I started writing down a few of the times in the sessions when Rachel did do her toning. And so if someone had the time and inclination, or also, Rachel, I'm not sure if you had written down times, but that would be most handy.
Okay.
And then you could, you know, clip, and then you can actually, there's always a lead-in. Frank will ask you to do a toning for this, this, this. So you can bring in that so that everyone can understand what it is, and that, or somebody could work with that. But I think that's a beautiful idea.
Maybe a link on Universal Mind Radio, tonings for different things. I don't know.
Tonings and the light language too.
Yeah.
Because I do know, like I just did that thing with Judy Satori, and that also might be too. I was thinking maybe why I'm being put down a little bit more too, because some of those light languages, I do get activations from them, and they work with me in ways I can't really understand. I just know it's powerful energy.
Well, it's because you're not supposed to know it quite at this time, meaning that if you did know, we're not able to have the same knowledge or understanding, so the time will come where it will all work together.
Yeah. Developing an understanding that's simply it's evolving. It's very beautiful.
Yeah, we can put a link on Universal Mind Radio to anything you want to create.
You could even have your own radio show at some point where you could share with others the excitement and the joy of, you know, vibration and frequency.
You know, as long as we're on that, I thought I could hear some background sound when we were bringing in the photon energy.
Yeah.
Let's open up, Rachel, and see if we can bring that sound in.
I heard a lot when you were working with Mike. There was like cricket sounds.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Wouldn't it be neat if we could get that stuff downloaded? And
I know that one day when we had that one session, man, that was powerful. I kept walking around my house going, holy smokes. Okay, here we go.
Now we're focusing on the photon flow. Open up your forehead. Thank you.
so relaxing.
Thank you.
Be healing for him as well.
You know, all of you, what came to me while listening to all of this is this downloading and this sound is activating all of those recessive DNA parts of our body and so forth. And if all of the earth could just hear this sound on how we would all behave differently, but we're all so involved in other musics and sounds and tones. And there's my example.
What tone is that?
That's a beautiful tone that Mike does.
Instead of the tones of the world, of the galaxy.
Oh, that's sweet. Thanks for sharing that, Mike.
Well, while you were saying that, part of the things I was doing was I was having it come in and I was sending it down to the earth and bringing it back up.
Yeah, me too.
Just cycling up and down, is breathing in and having it go back out.
Perfect. Gaia thanks you. But you know that already.
Yeah, plus doing it to myself. And so, you know, the DNA thing, I was going, hey, this is going to all my cells, it's rejuvenated, and seeing all my cells perfect and complete.
Precious, now we got another tool to work with. I didn't realize we were getting to the hibernating bears as well.
I was thinking those tones might bring in the galactic.
That's Dan, isn't it?
No, it's not Dan. It's
Mike.
She's fell asleep. She got so relaxed.
Then I thought it was Frank doing his heavy breathing.
Yeah, I did too for a minute. But
yeah, it's a different sound.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys, I'm going to go play with my granddaughters for a while. I love you all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, enjoy. Have a good time.
Thank you all for everything.
Bye-bye.
Okay, I guess we've got enough for tonight.
Yeah, it's a wonderful evening.
Okay, we're still broadcasting, so all the radio listeners out there, I guess we're going to be signing off.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night, Mike.
The whole world can hear Mike snoring, and that's the way it is.